parents. They're even worse than their fairy equivalents. Listen.
But everyone is going.
Everyone apart from you, my dear.
Going where? Ollie's having a blast at the diner. Ugh, yuck. Boys are so disgusting. Not that kind of blast.
Why can't Abby look after the little toad?
Abby's too young.
Well, I don't know. Tell Auntie Irene that you're busy. Why do you want to watch her holiday video anyway?
Believe me, Ella, I don't. The thought of it, her cavorting on a beach in that bikini, mounds of blubbering, bouncing, wrinkly white flesh, and the look of terror in those small children's eyes as she jumps for the frisbee. Grown men cowering behind their deck chairs as she heads towards the ice cream van.
So don't go. The consequences could not be any worse.
Oh, my dear, sweet, innocent child, you have no idea.
Oh, great! So, you are ruining my life because you're too much of a coward to say no to Auntie Irene. Thanks for nothing, Dad.
There is no bikini this year. No bikini, no costume, no nothing. She went on one of them nudist holidays, didn't she say? Everything will be flipping and flopping about.
He spoke to you.
And laughed at me.
What exactly did he say?
Things too horrible to repeat.
Roger. You really have been working far too hard lately. You really need to unwind. I'll tell you what, instead of dragging ourselves round to Irene's tonight, why don't we just take Jack Tempin bowling? Know how much you enjoy that? Hmm? Yeah.
Wicked plan. Ella will be delighted.
Yeah. Though I will also benefit from the situation. I should have known. Do you get it? Gnome. You've got to stop watching the Chuckle Brothers.
So, how exactly will you benefit?
Simple. If Ella couldn't go, nor could I.
But it's tonight, so you can't go anyway.
Of course I can. Rick's going.
Easy, girls. Sex God approaching.
Wow, you look wonderful.
Yeah, that's one word for it. Another is, Thorn, why are you wandering around in your vest painted gold? Don't sit.
Well, tonight's the fairy fancy dress party. I'm going as Apollo and you as Aphrodite. Remember?
That's what I was trying to tell you.
Rags! Rags! Oh, more rags!
Borrow something of mine if you like.
Not in a million years. Everything in your wardrobe is enough to make Trini and Susanna drop dead.
Oh, it's not a bad idea, actually. Should invite them round.
Where's a fairy when you need one?
I'm beginning to wonder whether you prefer human company to ours.
I have a duty to my human, just as you do to yours.
I don't go out partying with mine.
That's because yours is a geek.
Just because his hobby happens to be pure mathematics doesn't mean he's a geek.
What does it mean, then?
He's an extremely numerate geek. Look, mister, you have to escort me to this party.
I have to do nothing of the sort.
I'll go with you.
Snowdrop.
I shall go as Perfection. Oh, silly me, I'm that already.
I accept your gracious offer. Your perfection will complement my Apollo.
At twilight, come to the heath. Follow the gaze of every male, and that's where you'll find me.
Lost a daisy. Found a rose. Oh well.
She is such a pompous, self-conceited, beautiful.
For the last time, Misty, get your fairy butt down here now!
Duty calls.
I've been calling you since, like, yesterday.
I make it about 2 minutes.
Ow!
Sorry, Abby.
Detail. Now, are you gonna help me or what?
Seeing as you've asked so nicely, how could I possibly refuse?
Okay. The blast tonight, I want to look...
Well, let's not concentrate on how you want to look, but how you want people to see you.
How she wants Ollie to see her more like.
Shut it, fish breath.
Fish don't breathe, amoeba brain.
I'll brain you if you don't... Abby has a point. It's Ollie you're trying to pull, right?
As if. Okay, yes, but I don't know what he likes. I might not even be his type.
Though, how I couldn't be any guy's type is beyond me.
Well, that's what we gotta do then. We gotta find out what Ollie likes and give it to him.
Like, how?
Be right back.
So, with you making that noise and with Mrs. Cronkite's culinary skills, tonight cannot fail to be a success.
Making noise? I'll have you know that modern DJing is an art. Up there with art. I promise you that after tonight, Mr. K's will be put squarely on the map of hip.
These are munchies, Mr. K.
What is that?
This? Golapki.
Gobbly what?
No, no, no. Golapki. Cabbage leaves stuffed with rice. Delicious.
I'm sure it is, but when I said I wanted party food, I kind of...
Ollie, do me a favour, will you? Just nip out the back and tell Mrs. K you don't want any of this food that she spent the last 2 hours preparing and that you'd rather have chicken drumsticks instead. You can't miss her. She's the one with the beard and the blood-stained meat cleaver.
Actually, now I come to think of it, this is lovely. Really lovely.
Nice one.
Got him.
Okay, boys, it's truth time.
I wonder if you two charming young men will be kind enough to help me. I'm doing a survey on the perfect girl in the eyes of the cool teen.
So you come to the expert, wise thinking lady, fire away.
First question, what colour hair should she have?
Easy, blonde.
Blonde? And that's both of you?
Nah, not for me. I'd go for a red head.
You right, guy?
Whoa, man, there must be some serious static in here.
If we could get on. So that's blonde for both of you?
No. As I was saying, I'm a real sucker for redhead.
Both blonde, then?
Yeah, blonde. Blonde's the best.
Excellent. Now, how about body type?
She'd have to be leggy and tall. And blonde and green-eyed and leggy and tall and French.
Oh, man, French, good choice. No, what I meant was, non-French?
Excellent. Thanks for your help.
You are gorgeous.
Oh, well, thank you, but I think I'm a little too old for you, young man.
No, 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 not you, her.
Hi, I'm Sunbeam. I'm the new waitress.
Ah, come in. I'll get your uniform.
Excuse me?
What are you playing at?
I'm sorry?
Professor Dust will go ape if he catches you down here.
Right. Whatever you say.
Well?
Boys are so shallow.
Oh, not Ollie, he's different.
Oh, yeah? Ollie, dream girl. Blonde.
Blonde? What is it with men and blondes?
Green-eyed.
Oh, none out of two, just great.
And leggy.
None out of three. He wants Gwyneth Paltrow.
Is Gwyneth Paltrow French?
American.
Then he doesn't want Gwyneth Paltrow either.
How shallow can you get? Well, that's it then. There's absolutely no point in me going to the blast tonight.
That's where you're mistaken.
How? Unless you can magic me into a... leggy, green-eyed, blonde, French girl, I mean, do I look like a French girl to you? What has happened to me?
Mira.
Sacre bleu! This is maybe what he wants, but it is not who I am.
But that's what I've realized. Boys have no idea what they want. That's why we have to tell them.
Je ne comprends pas. I do not understand.
Well, Ollie will meet what he thinks is his dream girl, but in fact, it's you all along. His true dream girl. Now remember, your name's Isabel.
Oh man, you gotta check out. He just walked in with Misty.
Whoa, I think I've died and gone to heaven. No, she's giving me the eye.
Yeah, I think you're right. Just play it cool, yeah?
Did you see that? He winked at me, the fecal rat.
Well, of course he did. You're his perfect girl. Now go and say hello, and remember, charming, witty, sophisticated.
No, she's coming over.
Merci.
What?
Thank you.
All right, no props. I've not seen you around before.
Ah, no, I am from Française.
Française. Cool. Where's that then?
I'm really glad you made it tonight.
Yeah?
Yeah. When you came through that door, you just like...
One chocolate swirl?
Cheers.
I looked what?
Completely and utterly.
And one strawberry surprise. I am so sorry. It's all right. Missed.
Whoa, lucky escape.
Wasn't it?
I know where that is. Cool. I'm not gonna do this right. I'm from Ingoland. You wanna see my decks?
Pardon?
My decks. That's what I mix my tunes with.
Oui, bien sûr.
Hey, looks like Ollie's used his. Hey, do you wanna feed my deck slimes?
Well, it's more original than do you want to see my mushroom?
Yeah. What? Yeah.
Once again, I'm really sorry. You okay?
It's weird. I've been getting these, like, shocks all day.
Maybe some fresh air will help.
You can scratch CDs nowadays, but for me, vinyl is king.
You do it very well.
I'm gonna have my own place. Club at the front, recording studio at the back. Should I have a go?
No. It looks too difficult.
No. It's a breeze. What was that for?
In France, when we like a boy, we kiss him. You know, like?
Whoa. Look, Isabella, yeah? You're quite fit and all that, but...
But?
But there's this girl I'm kind of into, and she's meant to be here tonight, but she's done a no-show.
What is her name?
Ella?
One moment. Do not go away. I will, well, not me, but stay right here.
This is someone's garden.
Yeah, Ella's. It's all right, there's no one in.
Cool. Do you reckon there's life out there?
I'm sure of it.
It's funny, because when I was younger, I'd spend hours looking up at the night sky. All because Mum told me that if I saw a shooting star and made a wish, it would come true.
Quick, make a wish.
I wish that Misty would kiss me.
I think your wish is about to come true. Thorn, what are you doing here? And remove that spell from Rick.
Fairy dust runs through your veins, yet you insist on playing around with these humans.
And what concern is that of yours?
It is our destiny, to be together and live in the fairy world.
I'll make my own destiny, thanks.
I'm sorry it has to be like this.
Ricky, okay?
Yeah, I'm fine, Chiz. Why did you call me Rick?
Duh, it's your name.
Yeah, but how did you know that?
What have you done?
It's for your own good.
Rick? Ah, Rick, I've been looking everywhere. What are you doing here?
Hey, Sunbeam, do you know what? I haven't got a clue. You look stunning tonight. Come on.
I knew the likeness was too much of a coincidence. Put him down or I'll tell the professor!
It's pitiful, really. Your human friend will fall in love with whoever I choose, purely because I can make him believe it.
Well, make him unbelieve. Oh, there you are. I have been looking for you for ages. Oh la la. Who is that stuck to Rick's face? Soon to be dead fairy. Oh well. C'est la vie, as they say in France. He probably realized what an idiot you are. Now, change me back to myself. Ollie liked me. Ella, all the time. There was no need for your stupid charade. Isabel, out. Oh. Ella, in. Oh, here he comes.
Hi, girls. Look at Rick go with that. Fit waitress, talk about fast worker. All right, darling, letting off some air. Oh, I'm so glad to see you.
Yeah?
Yeah. There's this French bird, complete nutcase she is, and her breath was rank. Anyway, to get rid of her, I told her I had this crush on someone, and the first name that popped up into my head was yours. Ridiculous, I know. But there you go. Hope you don't mind.
No. It's fine.
I better get back to my decks.
Ugh. I hate boys. Detestable creatures. Going home. Coming? Yeah. Oh. One sec.